racing away from the 1400 meter mark. A nice beginning this one. Fashion Display with the black cap is right there. Tommaso, black and red, goes off to lead them. Hannah's Answer, the red cap, runs into second. They're followed further back by Art Attack, that's the black cab. Towards the outside, Shake Storm racing about four lengths off the leader at this stage. Power Horse has got about five lengths to make up, and then comes Brave and Bold as they settle down and they go towards the 800 meter marker. Tommaso and Craig Zaki leads it. Hannah's Answer and Muzieni, the red cap, second. Show Me Your Rosie, Alder De Mayo's at the rail in third position. Fashion Display, Brandon Lorino's back fourth. Then My Alicia and Bernard Fader, the blue cap, near the rail. Art Attack and Sean Veal is on the outside. Then Power Horse and Ryan Munger as they turn into the home stretch. Then the Matador and Richard Faree. Top of the lane, Tommaso leads it. Show Me Your Rosie. Art Attack's putting in a claim. My Alicia. Down the inside, Summy in the City and Raymond Danielson. Running on as Brave and Bold. Towards the outside as Hannah's Answer. It's wide open at the 200. Show Me Your Rosie. Brave and Bold's a big runner. Art Attack. Shake Storm's running on. But it's Show Me Your Rosie, the leader over the last 100. Show Me Your Rosie and Alder De Mayo have won it. Second to Brave and Bold and Greg Sheen. Then Shake Storm and Warren Kennedy, maybe Art Attack and Sean Veal run fourth. So the winner is number six, Show Me Your Rosie. That is victorious. Show Me Your Rosie. This is for Tony Riverland, and Alder De Mayo wins it for the Cape Eagles. The Cape Eagles also run second, and that's Brave and Bold and Greg Sheen. Third to number one, Shake Storm, and that's for the KZN Falcons and Warren Kennedy. And fourth also, that goes to Art Attack and Sean Veal for the KZN Falcons. Further back in the run was Hannah's Answer, and then came Power Horse. And they were followed over the line by Fashion Display and Brandon Lorino. Some in the City as well down the field. So it's 20 points for first, 16 for second, for third 14, for fourth 12, for fifth 10, and sixth place will get the 8. So you'll get updates on the total, but Show Me Your Rosie. And that is the winner, the Captain L, Tony Riverland and Alder De Mayo. And they come victorious and they end up tote favourite at 4:30 until the running of the fourth race. Back to the studio.
Good win. Leg one of the Ryder Cup, sponsored by New Turf Carriers. Nice to have Michael Sham on course. He's one of the directors of New Turf Carriers. Michael, thanks for coming down with helping us with the presentation. Of course, a bottle of champagne to the winning connections and a cash prize to the groom. Well, it's Show Me Your Rosie. She did go off as the top one here. A nice double for the Riverland stable, daughter of Captain L. And let's have a chat to the winning trainer. Tony, nice win, and you know, I kept mentioning the draw and what a major plus it could be for this filly, and it seemed to work out nicely for her.
Geez, that's exactly what worked out in her favour. You know, she's last time she found a lot of trouble in running from a bad draw, but he went. You know, she was travelling very well, turning for home, and he went a little early, but he really had no option. You know, and he's a very good rider, Alder. They ran for him, and I thought it was a good ride, and she did well. She was tenacious in the end. Kept onto the line, and I don't think it was the strongest of fields. I think that most probably helped us quite a bit, and I think pinching it at the top of the straight most probably turned out in her favour. She was very fit, but she often worries me. You know, she gets the front, she can kind of run around a little bit and that, but she's a pretty little filly. She's won three races. You know, well done to Boyland, well done to my partner Arthur Potts. He's on the golf course, and it's nice that she could notch up a win for us.
Well, if you can receive on behalf of yourself and of course the winning owner as well, Arthur Potts, so two bottles. Maybe let's get Terry in to represent Arthur. Come to Terry, come have a well done on USO. You quietly fancy this filly?
Yes, thanks very much, Deez. Big congratulations to Arthur. Obviously, Tony, the other partner. Arthur's a big support in the stable and he deserves every win he gets. Well done.
Well, that's a bottle of champagne for Arthur Potts. Thanks to Michael Sham, as I mentioned, coming down. And then the winning jockey, he'll take the lion's share of the points here for his team from Cape Town. But let's not forget, Greg Sheen back in second as well. So it's a good start for the team, Aldo.
Yeah, no, definitely. We couldn't ask for a better beginning. Let's hope we ended off in a similar fashion.
This filly on paper, she looked to have a serious winning chance with the draw swing around.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know a great deal about her, but I see she comes out a little bit slow and she normally comes from off the pace. But I had a bit of pace next to me and I thought it's quite imperative that I get her out the gates today, and I warmed her up thoroughly. And she gave me the impression that she's a little bit immature and she perhaps needs a couple of scoops, you know. And I got her out nicely and she was galloping with him, and I just elected to have one in front of me, and she was full of running. Mr. Rivlin told me prior to the race that she's pretty fit, and it's about as fit as he's had her. And I mean, if you take all that into consideration with the draw swing, everything was in her favour today. She was full of running coming to the straight, and the second she heard those horses coming at her, she just gave me another kick.
Well, it's over four races, this competition between the three provinces, but nice to have some big points on the board early.
Yeah, definitely. I think we've got a nice team together this year, much like we do every other year, but you've got to respect our opposition. They're all really top riders, and thanks to Newter for putting this initiative together for us. You know, it's nice for us to test our skills against the best in the country, and yeah, we really enjoy these kind of days, so thanks to them for the support.
I know you don't know many of your horses later on, but you would have had a look at the card. You single anything out that you could possibly have a double with?
Listen, it's difficult. I don't really know the other horses and their form so well, like you say. I think my next best rider will probably be the Platinum Runner. We're going to take unbeaten horse on there in the form of Koala. Yeah. But I think that she's perhaps a class above those. So if she takes it to Polly, I think she's going to be with a big shot there.
Well done to the team, yeah. That's the Cape Cobras, and nice start for you guys. And Aldo, a nice bottle of champagne as well for you.
Yeah, no, thanks, Deez. I said whatever happens today, at least we're not going to leave you being the worst-looking team.
And then the winning groom. Well done to him. Well done to the winning groom. A nice present for you there from Michael Sham. That's your cash prize, my man. Well done to the winning groom. Michael, thanks for coming down, assisting us with that presentation. And, yep, that's it. It's a fancy horse. The favorite is obliged in the first leg of the Pick 6 race number 3. Up next, our last exotic will be the jackpot, and 14:15, 2:15.